Hoosier City School District is holding a public meeting this evening to discuss possible plans in zone reconfiguration. Parents, students, and staff are invited to share thoughts and feedback as it relates to transportation, neighborhood schools, and how buildings are used. Fairly significant stuff when it comes to how the district is run. Ericetta Koss tells us more about what this means for parents.
You may be wondering, what is zone configuration? Janelle Morris, Deputy Superintendent of Teaching and Learning for the district, says, picture the district on a map divided into three zones. Students are assigned schools based on where they live in each zone. They also determine transportation lines. Morris says the district wants to re-examine this map after parents raised concern about access when it comes to schools they want to go to and programs they desire.
For example, parents have raised that there might be a school that you might want your student to attend, but it's closer to the home. And because of current policies and laws, we don't offer transportation necessarily to a school of preference.
That's just one example of multiple concerns being raised. The conversation tonight will be the first step in discussing how can the district remove any barriers parents may be feeling. Adam Urbanski, president of Rochester Teachers Association, criticizes the effort, saying he simply doesn't trust it.
They are determined to make program cuts and to close schools a year from now, and they want to use these forums as justification for making for school closings.
But Morris says this is simply a response to parent concerns and systemic barriers. No decisions will be made in the immediate future or school year. It's merely discussion. Right now, the district says the most important part of it all is keeping communication open and honest with parents.
Where we're going to ask the public to weigh in and let us know if we're meeting their needs.
Reporting, Ericetta Koss, News 8.
Ericetta, thank you. The public hearing is taking place right now, and we'll have all the latest updates for you on News 8 at 11 and, of course, over on RochesterFirst.com.